Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be doing a video that'll be introducing a series that I myself am pretty excited about, and it's going to be a pretty long-term series going at least throughout the year 2020, but it's going to be a series following my progression, hopefully, as a precision long-range shooter, and this is the rifle I'm going to be hopefully doing that around, and so I'm just going to be kind of introducing this series and telling you what kind of setup I'm going to be, at least again, starting out with. Now, you may have already heard, but we have some nasty winter weather coming in, so if it's windy, I apologize. Hopefully you can still hear me, but I'm going to go ahead and power through because I really just need to get this video done. So really quick, I'm going to try to knock out an overview of what I have here and what I'm going to be starting the series with. And this is a Hawa Model 1500, one of their mini actions, chambered in 223. There's a very specific reason I chose 223, but I'll cover that here in a minute. All I've done to this rifle, as far as how it comes configured from the factory, is relieve the stock up here by the barrel. The reason I did that was in some of the early testing when I was making sure everything was squared away. I was getting weird groups where I was getting like two or three really, really tight shots and then two several inches off to either side. And so I figured possibly that's due to the stock coming in contact with the barrel. So I relieved that out a little bit and things have tightened up, so we're good to go there. This one did not come with a scope on it. Some of the Hawa mini actions do. This one is one that I mounted myself. So I have a Vortex Diamondback Tactical, one of their new tactical line scopes. This is one of their four, I believe it's a 4-16. Yep, 4-16 front focal plane with some exposed target turrets and adjustable parallax on the side. This is not illuminated, but it does have some of the features that I wanted, i.e. the ability to adjust the turrets on the fly without having to take a cap off, and having that parallax adjustment on the side because of the ranges that I foresee shooting this rifle at. I've got a Harris bipod mounted up here on the front. Bipod may stay or it may go, but at least for now I have the Harris bipod up here in the front. And then just to make this rifle fit me, I did have to do a couple things. So first of all, I have my yoga mat special. My girlfriend made me buy a yoga mat many years ago, and all I've ever done with it is cut it into pieces to make cheek risers. So I've got that wrapped up just to get my cheek to a comfortable height to be able to look through the scope. And then I added a Limb Saver recoil pad because 223 is a very aggressively recoiling round. But honestly, it's actually because the length of pull was not long enough, even with this scope mounted as far forward as I can. So while the Hawa 1500s have the same bases as the Remington 700, because it's a mini action, you can't use the single piece one. So I'm stuck using these two pieces, which doesn't let me get that scope mounted very far forward. Subject to change, but at least that's how I have it configured right now. So, why did I pick 223 to start this series with? So, when I first started trying to get into shooting bolt guns, the issue I ran into was I was wasting a lot of money trying to learn some very beginner lessons. I was shooting a 308, and I decided I was going to start with really nice ammo so that I could tell, you know, what was me versus what's the equipment. And if I use good ammo, then obviously anything that's wrong is going to be with me. However, there was a lot that I had to learn and a lot that I had to overcome. And so when you're spending $1.50 a shot trying to learn those lessons, it gets very expensive very quickly, and it gets you to the point where you either can't afford to continue or you don't want to continue. Also, as a beginner, the extra recoil of the 308 definitely did add some psychological barriers with being able to control trigger control properly and all that kind of thing with anticipating the recoil. And so my logic with the 223 is A, it's very readily available and cheap ammo to where I can shoot this thing very affordably. And if someone is wanting to follow along in this journey, they can find 223 ammo anywhere and get some pretty decent quality ammo at a pretty affordable price, under a dollar around usually for good quality ammo. And with 223, because it's softer recoiling, you can really focus on your fundamentals because it's softer recoiling without having to worry as much about anticipating recoil and all those things. If you're still really, really new to shooting, you can also start with a 22 long rifle, learn a lot of lessons there. But for me, I wanted to already start with a rifle that I can range out to 600 yards with potentially, and 223 is gonna hopefully afford me that opportunity. So as far as the details on the series that I'm going to be doing, as I mentioned, it's going to be kind of following my journey to get better at long-range precision shooting. I want to make it very clear that I am not an expert in this, and this is also not a series of me learning how to be a sniper. Snipers and long-range precision shooters, while there may be a Venn diagram with a little bit of overlap, are two very separate things. Being a good PRS shooter, like those precision rifle shooting matches, versus being good at the field craft required to be a good sniper, are very different skills generally. So I just want to make it clear that if you're looking to a series like this to see how to become a sniper, this is not the series to use. Or if you're looking for expert opinion, this is not the series to use. Again, this is just going to be me documenting my journey to hopefully become a better precision rifle shooter. So I kind of want to set some goals for this series as far as like what I would define as being a good precision rifle shooter. And my goal by the end of 2020, at least with this rifle here, if I haven't already upgraded to some sort of 308 or 6.5 Creedmoor, is to be able to get first round hits out to 600 yards, hopefully, and then at least be able to get consistent hits out to about 800 yards. And so that's kind of the goals that I have in line with this rifle for where my skills are at by the end of 2020. And I can tell you pretty confidently, while I haven't tried, I don't think I could do that right now, especially not with a 223. So what kind of videos am I going to be making in this series? So first of all, obviously this introduction video, but I'm going to be doing a video showing how to find a load that your rifle likes. And then I'm also going to be doing a video showing how I'm going to be developing a hand load for this rifle. Now, I've already done a little bit of preliminary testing, as I mentioned, so I've already got a pretty good idea and I've already got kind of the beginnings of a hand load developed. But I'm going to be kind of showing you a little bit more in depth about that as I go. Now, one of the other things that I'm going to be covering is how I'm going to be developing a dope book for this thing, and I'm going to be doing that in a couple different ways. First of all, I'm going to be showing you the app that I'm going to be using to go with this scope that I can dial all my ballistic data into to get good, at least, starting points for my different distances and winds and everything else. And then I'm also going to actually shoot at some hopefully longer distances to be able to confirm a lot of that data. Now, if you've been following my channel for a while, you know that the range that I usually shoot at only allows me at most 290 yards and only 200 yards if I want to shoot on paper. However, I am working with a local gentleman who has a range that I can shoot out to almost 1,000 yards, which should really allow me to get a lot better at long-range precision shooting by actually doing it. Now, one of the other reasons that this is going to be a long-term series is I also want to talk about, especially once I develop a hand load or have a factory load that I know works with this rifle pretty well, I want to be able to show how different temperatures affect that dope book and where your point of impact is versus your point of aim at given distances and different velocities based on temperature. And so now, starting in January, being able to go through till probably next December of 2020, if not January of 2021, we should get a nice fluctuation of temperatures across this year to be able to hopefully identify what sort of differences there are, how much of a difference they can make, or hopefully with the powders that I'm going to be choosing for my hand loads, hopefully how temperature insensitive those are. So like I've already stated and hopefully stated a couple times at this point, I am not an expert in this topic. I am a reasonably proficient shooter, but by no means a long-range precision shooter. So I'm going to be defaulting to a lot of, I guess I'll use the phrase subject matter experts along this way. So hopefully that'll include me taking a couple long-range precision rifle classes in 2020. But if you guys out there are people who know what you're doing or do this on a regular basis and you want to add your recommendations and your suggestions, please by all means feel free to include that down in the comment section below on this video or any of the videos in this series or really in any of my videos on this channel in general. Now, speaking of the channel, due to the nature of some of the videos, i.e. things like load development and load data and all that and reloading, not all the videos will be here on YouTube. There are going to be some that are only exclusively going to be on places like Full 30 or GunStreamer due to YouTube's restrictions on showing how to, you know, reload ammunition. But as much as I can, I'll keep it here on YouTube. And when there is videos elsewhere, I'm going to be letting people know that via my Facebook page, or if you subscribe to my channel over on Full 30 or GunStreamer, you'll be able to see that as well. So I'm really looking forward to this series. I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a primer and explain one of the things that I'm going to be doing for 2020 as far as videos go, And it's something that I'm really looking forward to doing. Hopefully you guys can learn along the way as I learned some things myself. Really quick, I want to say thanks to my patrons for making videos like this one possible. There's going to be a significant investment in both time and material to be able to get this series done, and contributions over on places like Patreon are what really make that possible. As you guys, I'm sure, are well aware, YouTube is actively demonetizing channels and even taking down lots of videos from channels. By having a ready support system over on Patreon is going to make this series a lot more easy to do and will hopefully allow me to get a lot more done in this series. So if you want to support the channel over there, or if you want to get on our live streams or Q&As or anything like that, definitely head over to my Patreon page and start becoming a supporter over there. And then I also want to say that, at least as of this point, none of this stuff is sponsored. All this stuff was paid for by myself or using the contributions from Patreon, because I want to be as separated from companies as possible. However, with SHOT Show coming up, that may change, but my goal is to be as unbiased in this series as possible. So if I find out that this scope sucks and doesn't track properly, you're going to know about it. If I find out that this rifle sucks and doesn't shoot well, you're going to know about it. And obviously I'm going to be doing dedicated reviews of each individual component of this series as I get time on it and have a what I feel to be an educated opinion on it at that time. So if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, go ahead and throw those in the comment section down below. I'll try to get back to you as quick as I can. And like I said, if you want to be able to follow everything that's going on, definitely follow my Facebook page or my Instagram page, where I'm going to be posting a lot about this kind of stuff. But anyway, with all that being said, as always, I hope you got something out of this video, and I really appreciate you watching.